Hello guys, it's Darksigner here from the German Duel Masters channel and welcome back to another video. Today we got the finals from IDC 8 for you guys, where we have Halfar playing at the bottom of your screen with Fortress Mana Burn and Hymne at the top of your screen with Hydro Hurricane. And we sped up the game again a bit and I commented afterwards so you don't have to sit through the entire thing in real time in a control mirror. That can be quite annoying. And good start by Halfar. Turn 3 logic cube, searched lost soul, so if he can win the lost soul race he can get rid of the whole hand by Hymne. Lokomotiva sniping the lost soul out of the hand, which is quite unfortunate for Halfar, as he would have won the race easily with the Sky Sword here. And kind of a bit of lucky play by Hymne, but it got rewarded. And he plays the turn 5 Mistrias, which is very nice. And here we see a crucial misplay by Halfar. He should have given Hymne the Laura Giga or the Petrova. By giving him the trash crawler with the soul swap, he got rid of the Mistrias, which is very good. But Hymne can just play it again next turn. Let's see if Halfar decides to search a second lost soul. So then, assuming Hymne plays Mistrias, he can just lost soul him. But he goes for the soul swap instead. Maybe if he has a Bronze Arm Tribe in hand, he can charge the new draw, play Bronze Arm Tribe, and then burn 2 mana with Fortress Shell. But he just searched the soul swap as another out to Mistrias. He doesn't have water access at this moment, so Miraculous Snare isn't an option. That's why he chose soul swap. But I think he realized that swapping in the trash crawler wasn't that great in hindsight, because he just got back one Mistrias for free and he had to remove it one additional time. And you see Halfar doing his very best to get rid of all of the Mistrias, not giving him any draw options. But he has the energy stream, which is very nice, and can follow it up with the Paleolysis. So you see the board is quite huge already, so Hydro Hurricane is quite devastating already, bouncing all the creatures and 2 mana. Of course, Hymne wants to have like at least 2 or maybe 3 light creatures more in the battle zone. So, like this now. at this point, I think it's beneficial to use Hydro Hurricane. And Halfar again searches back the Soul Swap, and now the last target in mana is Petrova, and he has to get it out. But he got rid of 3 Mistrias, that's quite good. Now all he has to do is deal with the board, or at least start burning mana. Because if he burns mana, the board isn't really that impactful, because only the Marrow Ooze, 2 Marrow Ooze, Lokomotiva and Petrova can attack. And Hymne with all the draw cards here, another energy stream, and follows it up with the 4th Mistrias. So, 3 Mistrias are gone. Halfar dealt with 3 of them, and like he dealt with it 4 times, because one was played 2 times. So, can't really do too much with Hymne seeing all of his Mistrias that early in the game. Quite unfortunate for Halfar in this situation, and he can remove the Fortress Shell, and with that I think it's just a matter of time until Hymne starts firing Hydro Hurricane and locking the game here. I don't see Halfar really making a comeback here. Let's see what he top decks. A Plague, that's quite nice, but Hymne will definitely keep the Mistrias just, so it's just a bounce and not really dealing with it. And yeah, he just casually placed the Mysterious for the fifth, or no, the sixth time in this game. Maybe I should have added a Mysterious counter, how many times he got summoned. And yeah, the Bronze Arm top deck, yeah, that's one of the worst top decks. Like, probably one of the best cards in turn 3 to kickstart your game, but one of the worst top decks. That's, yeah, the bad part about it, but yeah, I think it's worth the risk top decking it, yeah, late. Like, yeah, two in a row, that's just harsh, not really Halfar's game here. Yeah, meanwhile we could talk about how the tournament went up until now. The records, like, Halfar went undefeated until this point, and I think he won every match 2-0. Like, he 2-0'd everybody, didn't even drop a single game, and also 2-0'd Hymne in the group stage. But yeah, looking like a different story here in the finals, at least for game one. And the first Hydro Hurricane drops, so Halfar's yeah, got set back quite a bit. Can place Sky Sword and Essence Elf to at least hide behind a few shields and ramp a bit mana back up so he can stay in the game. Like, 7 mana is a pretty reasonable amount, you can do very much. But now, yeah, he just scoops the second Hydro Hurricane. Yeah, that would have cleared just all the mana, or at least maybe all but one, something like that, and all the creatures. And yeah, there's no way you can come back from that with yeah, Hymne having that huge board presence and Halfar only having yeah, 1 to 3 mana, something like that. There's no way, so he just scoops it up, and we are just getting right into it in game two. And the Bronze Arm tribe after the Essence Elf, a very nice start. It looks pretty similar to his semi-finals game 2 against Solomon, where he had Essence Elf into Bronze Arm Tribe into Lost Soul, which is like the perfect progression. Let's see if he has it again. Yeah, wow. I think that one doesn't seal the game, but it's really shifting the game into Halfar's favor, like, quite a bit. If he can start burning mana next turn by using Soul Swap for the Fortress Shell, I think it's over. Yeah, at least Hymne gets his hand advantage back with the Zombie Carnival. That was a nice play here. But if Halfar can play Soul Swap here, yeah, which he does, I think this starts shifting the game in a very, very difficult position for him. He has, like, the cards back, but all he can do, the best he can do, is play Mysterious now and hope Halfar doesn't have an answer. And, like, even Halfar doesn't specifically have to have an answer. Okay, he has it in Miraculous Snare, but, like, he could have just burned more mana with another Fortress Shell than, like, all the draw from Rias. Yeah, that wouldn't really matter if he can't play anything. And yeah, this time he decides to get rid of the Rias and swap in the Laura Giga. Maybe I would have just played the Fortress Shell to get him down to 4 mana this turn and give him the draw. But I can understand that if you can remove the Rias, and from public knowledge Hymne doesn't have another one, you cut him off of his draw engine entirely, then yeah, you can burn mana later. Maybe that was ultimately the right play, but just, yeah, giving you maybe insight that he could have done it differently. But yeah, I don't know Halfar's hand. Maybe yeah, okay, he has another Fortress Shell. Maybe he just thought to himself, yeah, get rid of the problem first, I can still mana burn later. And now you see the Hydro Hurricanes not being that great early on in the game. Like, the opposite to Bronze Arm Tribe, you want to see them late game as top decks, but not early game. You can just charge it, they don't really do too much early game. And Halfar with the Faliga, which immediately gets him back to the soul swap, which leads to another fortress shell summon. And yeah, that's what the deck does here. Hymne is still at 5 mana, which is quite okay, but that ensures he can only play one thing per turn and not play multiple creatures, multiple spells, and such. And yeah, Halfar digging for more options with the stream probably didn't get anything to burn more mana, anything really useful. And if he has removal, I would have not played it as well and wait for the Mistrias to come down. That's what I said like multiple times in my semifinals match against Hymne. You don't really need to use removal. He does it on Paleolesis, but I quite disagree because Halfar doesn't play fire, so the power of the creatures is irrelevant anyways, but yeah, ultimately it pays off as he gets discarded by Lost Soul, so at least he got some value out of his hand. And yeah, it was another miraculous Nan hand, of course. Yeah, I didn't know that, because if the miraculous Nair was his only removal, I would have definitely held it back for Mistrias, but as he had two, it was the right play, getting at least some advantage out of your cards and getting rid of the Paleolesis. But otherwise, I would have kept it in hand for when Hymne plays Mistrias. And yeah, Fall into Zombie Carnival, that's a very good play. But the Cryptic Totem, yeah, that might be a problem here, because if Hymne doesn't get another blocker on board or gets rid of the Cryptic Totem, but okay, never mind, he gets rid of the Cryptic Totem immediately by the top decked Miraculous Snare. But otherwise, he would have been in a very rough spot, and he decides to take back the two Locomotivers instead of some Guardians. Interesting. Maybe he thinks he can make Halfar top deck more with this pressure by Locomotiver. And I remember now during the game he said he needed the Locomotivers just as attackers. Like, yeah, he plays them not because he wants to discard stuff, but he's significantly behind in the deck out race. I'm sorry that I don't go over Hymne's deck here to see on how many cards he is exactly. But he told us during the game he needs attackers because he needs to finish the game by attacking. And he's not in the best position to attack, as Halfar has a very nice board there. So yeah, just looking at the situation now, I think Halfar is in the winning position, but like I said that since the Lost Soul play in turn 4. And here you see a very nice tech choice by Halfar, which is the Spiral Gate. He used the same combo in the semifinals already to bounce back his Fall Eager and get back Plague. He could have also just bounced the Fortress to burn 2 mana, but he wants to recycle the Plague because that way he also gets rid of some cards on board. So Plague at this point being the better play, although you give him the more cards in hand, but that's not really that impactful now, because Halfar also knows that Hymne has to attack him to win the game. He can't just sit it out and go for deck out. Yeah, the Gleaner here might be a problem if Halfar doesn't find an out to it. Those two shields were set by Miraculous Snare, so there was no shield trigger possibly coming out from those shields. Let's see if Halfar top decked removal here, which he didn't, but I think, yeah, he just gave him back the Cryptic Totem, and that pressures him to have removal. I hope Hymne has some form of removal, otherwise that would have been a very bad play to give him back the Cryptic Totem. And he scoops. Oh no, Hymne, what did you do? Giving him back the cryptic totem, ultimately made him lose game two here. Yeah, maybe he didn't think about it, or yeah, didn't want to attack into possible shield triggers and wanted to just, yeah, give the safe shields and didn't think about the possibility of just losing to hardcast cryptic totem. But yeah, we are deciding IDC 8 in game 3, so I hope for you guys watching it's enjoyable, because for me, myself, I think this is a very good, very competitive match between those two guys. And yeah, seeing such a match go to game 3 is always a pleasure. And Halfar, yeah, kind of lucky that he charged the light, as he took out the light mana with the soul swap, but yeah, butt into Soul Swap for Sky Sword is of course a nice way to ramp up your mana and maybe just play the Lost Soul next turn. Yeah, Hymne doing his best, playing the Mistrias to distract Halfar from playing Lost Soul, but I think if he has it, he plays it anyway, because next turn he can be Lost Soul if he doesn't. Okay, so he doesn't have it, I guess. Because otherwise I would have definitely played my own Lost Soul. Just hope that the opponent doesn't draw a creature to snowball with Mistrias, because now if Hymne has the Lost Soul, he can just charge one and play it. But tapping one, yeah, that doesn't look like a Lost Soul, but another Mistrias followed by one or two one drops, yeah, just one, but still very good follow-up for the Mistrias, and having it on board always pressures the opponent to deal with it. And he bounces it back and plays a Belix and gets the Terror Pit here, which is definitely going to be an out for Mistrias. I quite like the choice by Halfar to go for Terror Pit instead of Miraculous Plague, as Miraculous Plague basically just bounces the Mistrias, and Terror Pit definitely deals with it, so yeah, I kind of agree. But Hymne has a Locomotiva to get rid of the Terror Pit first. Halfar just playing Sky Sword just to improve his board presence wise and charging the mana for free, and he's I think not really in danger of losing the deck out race, as Hymne drew quite a lot of cards already, and Halfar plays the bigger deck anyway. And yeah, the top deck Terror Pit for Mistrias, that was definitely needed. It was a very good draw. I think the game is a bit more in favor of Hymne here, because he has like such a huge card advantage in hand and can just drop Mistrias over and over again. But yeah, maybe a top deck Lost Soul and a bad top deck by Hymne can yeah, equalize things here. And also I think, to be honest, maybe just playing Cryptic Totem again could be a good thing for Halfar, as he then just needs to find a way to remove the blockers, and then yeah, or like not even remove the blockers, just to keep doing what he does, keep spamming bodies on board, and then just finish the game by Cryptic Totem instead of mana burning Hymne down. Because at this point, starting the mana burn strategy, yeah, it's quite difficult, because you can burn 2 mana every time, and maybe if you're lucky you can burn 4 in the turn, but yeah, Hymne got quite quite high here in mana. Unfortunately for Halfar, he has another Locomotiver and discards Lost Soul, which would have like at least equalized both hands. And let's see what he takes back. Yeah, the Lost Soul just again with Faliga, just saying, Hymne, you better have another Locomotiver, otherwise I will Lost Soul you. And Hymne playing right into the Lost Soul, hoping to draw an answer to it now. Yeah, because like if he top decks his own Lost Soul, he can discard it, and I think that Lost Soul for one would be very good. And now I think he just wants to put as many bodies on board. Oh no, oh, okay, yeah, oh, the Hydro Hurricane. Yeah, that's another application for Hydro Hurricane. You can win the Lost Soul race, basically. You can prevent the opponent from Lost Souling you. And having like three darkness and three light cards as like probably the perfect split here at this point. Getting rid of Halfar's board and start to burn mana. Halfar charging a bit here. Maybe he should have kept the water mana, and then he could have done maybe something else, but yeah, not looking too great with only 6 mana and the second Hydro Hurricane. Oh no, this game really swings at this point now. And I said it was already in Hymne's favor a bit, and now there's nearly zero comeback potential for Halfar. I think the only thing is hoping for good shield triggers and decking Hymne out. That's the only way you win this game now. And Hymne realizing this, of course, and starts to immediately swing now after he gained so much tempo, because he really needs to finish Halfar before he can start make a comeback. And Halfar just swapping the butt in and out to maybe ramp to 5 mana now, so he can play Sky Sword and defend himself a bit more. There I was quickly on Hymne's deck, but I didn't quite catch the number. Definitely the play to go, I think. Playing another Sky Sword, getting a bit of mana back, maybe. Yeah, now next turn he's in Lost Soul range and could make a comeback that way. If, of course, the triggers are good enough to keep him alive. And the third Hydro Hurricane, that seals the game. Like, what do you do against three Hydro Hurricanes? He bounces all the cards from Halfar, and with only 3 mana next turn, he's definitely not dealing with any of the cards on Hymne's board. And he also has the Petrova to safely attack for game next turn. I think this game is pretty much over. Like, Bronzam Tribe is the best play hit and hope to hit a Sky Sword. So yeah, and it's not a Sky Sword, so that maybe a lost Soul Swap in shields keeps you alive. But even then, like, what do you do? And he does the Locomotive play here. I thought he followed up with a Lost Soul as well, but not this time. But he swiftly goes in here after triple Hydro Hurricane, and that makes Hymne the IDC 8 champion. And heartbreaking loss for Halfar, of course, going undefeated before this. But Hymne takes it, becoming a 2-time champion with the same deck with Hydro Hurricane. We will update the deck for you guys on this channel, of course. And if you guys are interested in participating in one of our upcoming IDC tournaments, feel free to leave a message for Halfar on Discord. I will leave his Discord name down in the description below for you guys from now on. And you can just message him there, and then he will invite you into our IDC Discord server, where all the action goes down for our IDC tournaments. And I hope you guys enjoyed this match, and see you guys at another video.